Kaveri, the sacred river of southern India. It rises on Brahmagiri Hill of the Western Ghats in southwestern Karnataka state, flows through the states of Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, and descends at the Eastern Ghats in a series of great waterfalls. The river is celebrated for its scenery and sanctity, and its entire course is considered holy ground. On the sinuous river bank, branches of black plum, fig, and tamarind trees interlace with those of the Arjuna trees, creating an uninterrupted arboreal bridge that runs for many kilometers. This is the wildest terrain along the Kaveri's 800-kilometer route. These trees now face the threat of deluge. At Meketatu, which is located inside the sanctuary and borders Tamil Nadu, a controversial dam project has been proposed by Karnataka. It will provide drinking water to Bengaluru city, situated 100 kilometers from the sanctuary. Once the dam is built, most parts of the sanctuary will get inundated, submerging nearly 1 lakh wild trees, some of which have stood here for centuries. Representing the victims of the deluge among the flora and fauna is a seemingly small rodent that belongs to the genus of giants, the gristle giant squirrel, named so for its salt and pepper fur. Shy and elusive, these are entirely dependent on riverine vegetation, the kind that grows along the rivers. Endemic to South India and Sri Lanka, gristle giant squirrels face a population decline owing to the dwindling habitat everywhere. The near-threatened gristle giant squirrel is one of the three varieties of giant squirrels found in India. Less than 500 gristle giant squirrels are left in the country. Of these, less than 50 call the Kaveri Wildlife Sanctuary their home. A decrease in canopy cover not only decreases the amount of real estate available to them, but also exposes them more to their predators. If they exit from here, the richness of Karnataka's wildlife will diminish. While people of Bengaluru have been vocal against cutting trees for widening roads, not a word has been spoken yet against the proposed dam project. For now, Tamil Nadu is the only active protester against the construction of the dam. It claims that water inflow into its territory will be restricted. Environmental activists are being cautious in their protests as it is a matter of state chauvinism. The dam site is located 3 kilometers downstream of Sangama, the confluence of the Kaveri, and one of its tributaries, Arkavati. The river Rishabhavati originates in Bengaluru and later joins Arkavati as a tributary. The polluted river pumps 500 million liters of sewage water daily into the Arkavati, which will end up in the dam in future. That water from the dam will be pumped back as drinking water to Bengaluru. Already, the fecal coliform bacteria level in the Arkavati has doubled in a month. If the dam project becomes a reality, the whole flora and fauna of this area will get wiped off. The big question is, will there be a Noah's Ark to the rescue?